And now it's time for your favorite game show, Who Wants to Be a Spiritual Millionaire, featuring me! Today we have two amazing contestants. Our first guest is rumored to have a pet dinosaur named Nessie while growing up in Scotland. Let's give a warm welcome to Grandpa McLuther. Oh, it's sure great to be here this morning, and would you believe that time our second guest didn't shave for 2 whole months and was later confused with Bigfoot? Please let us welcome Zeke.
Many people in one place. They had 2 for 1 on a soda cart.
Damn it, pick it
with you.
Well, that's great, Zeke. I have no idea what you just said. So without further ado, let us start the game. This week's theme will be Preparing for the Lord. Our show will consist of a series of questions that...
Preparing for the Lord, huh? Now, I don't mean to cut you off there, young man, but I can tell you a few stories about preparing for the Lord. You see, back in the day, my friend Pontius was my co-pilot, of course. Well, we helped Lewis and Clark through the wilderness.
You don't say.
Yep. You could say they were much like John, who was out there in the wilderness, particularly predicting the coming of the Lord, our Savior Jesus.
Well, Lewis and Clark, huh? Well, did I ever tell you a time Christopher Columbus and I discovered America? Yep, Chris and I rode the wild seas together, and I was there helping point out the dangers along the way. Much like John told people about the dangers and pitfalls that cloud people's lives. And I told them to clean up their act. Now, gentlemen, having got to the questions, we see we're on a time crunch and the ratings. Oh, the ratings.
Now, don't you get your feathers in a ruffle there, Ryan Tamer. You know, it looks like you got spots there on your suit. Anyways, you and Christopher Columbus, huh? Well, don't that just beat all? I have to tell you the time I was lost in the wilderness with only my thoughts and a bear named Baloo. Yep. One day while Baloo and I were scratching against some tree, I heard a voice. It was all like,
Zeke, I need you to come out of the wilderness and help spread the message of Jesus.
And I was like, oh, shucks, Lord, you betcha. He thinks that's how John wants to fail.
Now, Zeke, Grandpa, we really must try to stay on point here. We've still got a show to do, and
don't you worry about your wee shoulder, young man. You need to be patient, especially this time of year. So you heard a voice and it helped lead you out of the wilderness and onto a better road of life. Amazing. But did I ever tell you the time I helped Martin Luther nail his 99 braces? Now, wait a minute. I thought there were only 95 pieces.
Patience!
Now then, Luther was pretty tired from writing all night, so I helped him nail his paper on the church door. Yep, Luther was trying to help explain the distractions people have in their lives when it comes to truly understanding Jesus. Luther also helped explain that you didn't have to earn your way into heaven. The way was already prepared for us by Jesus, which is why we prepare for him and his arrival this time of the year.
Well, what a wonderful story segment. Now we really must get to our first question. Here we go. In what year...
Hey, wait there a minute, Mick Luther. Are you actually related to Luther? Get it? Mick Luther and Luther? Oh, never mind. Hey, what do you say we go find us a morning snack around here before that there kiddo and swallow them all up?
Well, that sounds like a good plan, little Zeke. Especially before that stinky fella comes around. Yes. Last time you ate up all the cookies and I had this burning in my nose, I... Phew!
Stinky, huh? Boy, that reminds me of the time I was wandering the desert with Moses.
You don't say.
Well, that's our show for today, folks, and the winner is... me! Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And as always, keep on through.